Hi everyone, here in this video we are going to talk about import of products from e-commerce system into Odoo. First of all, we suggest you to import products after finishing initial import and linking all these objects between Odoo and e-commerce system. So we finish initial import, we are going to the mapping, we are linking all the attributes, categories, features and all these objects, and then we can start receiving products. Before starting receiving products, I want to show you what information we are receiving from e-commerce system into Odoo. If we'll go to the configuration, we can see two menus, product fields mapping and all product fields. All product fields is mostly a technical menu and it is visible only in the back mode. We can see the list of all default mapping for product fields, so we suggest you not to edit. But here you have ability to create some custom mapping. For example, you can map some PrestaShop field to Odoo fields. So let's go to the product fields mapping. Here we can see the list of e-commerce fields, which are corresponding to some Odoo fields, like prices, categories, tags groups, weight, and so on. When we do a first import of products, we can specify what fields you are planning to receive by these checkboxes, active. So we are receiving only active product fields. When we will be doing further updates of the product, you can also specify the behavior by activating or disabling these checkboxes. Send field for updating and receive field on import. And we will be updating only the active ones. So let's go to the integration, initial import tab. And to start receiving products, we simply need to click on link products button. But before doing it, I want to tell you some key requirements. We are linking products between e-commerce system and Odoo by SKU or internal references. So these fields should be unique. There shouldn't be any duplicates and they shouldn't be empty. All of them should be filled. Another thing that I want to notice is related to the product structure. If you are planning to link some configurable products, for example, from PrestaShop into Odoo, and in PrestaShop there is a product, there is configurable product with three variants, it will be possible only to link to the configurable products with three variants in Odoo. It will be impossible to link configurable product with three simple products in Odoo. So all these requirements you can find in our special article on our support portal. I will link it to this video. When we click in on link products, the system, first of all, will run product validation tests. It will check all the products in Odoo and PrestaShop. And if there are any problematic products without internal references or with duplicated internal references, we will see them in this list. And before receiving them, we need to fix it. Maybe it can take some time, but this is a very important step. So we suggest you to fix all the products before receiving them. After fixing them and clicking on link products button again, the connector will start receiving products and they will appear in the mapping and external. So you can find the products in the external, products, information about the code, external names and so on, and the same for product variants. So let's go to the mapping products menu. Here we can see the list of products which were not mapped. In this list, for example, in my case, it's only one product, wood panel. When we're clicking on link products button, the connector will try to find the product with the same SKU, and if it will find them, they will be linked. They will be visible and linked to some products. If not, we have some options what we can do with not mapped product. First option is manually map to already existing product in order. For example, if I know that this product corresponds to some another product from this list, I can go to the drop-down menu, choose the necessary one, and they will be linked. But make sure that the user is responsible for the manual mapping. And the structure of products also should be the same. Configurable product with three variants should be mapped to three variants in Odoo. And if we are making manual mapping, we need to map templates in the products menu and variants in the product variants menu. Okay, then another button is try to map. If the product is visible here, that means that the connector couldn't find the product with the same internal references, but we have ability For example, we have ability to fix and edit internal reference for the corresponding product in order. And after changing the internal references, I can click on try to map button and the connector will try to find the corresponding product with the same internal references again. And the last option is import product or create as a new one. So when I click on import product button, this product will be created as a new one. I can do the same action by activating all these checkboxes. For example, if I have empty order database, I receive 100 product, I select all of them and click on import product, all this product will be created as a new one. So this is how it works. Thank you.